Hello guys, welcome for another video on the Nashorn restoration. I'm Rob, and as you can see, painting was mostly finished except for the part that I still need to cut, but also need to cut another hole here. I don't know for what reason that hole is there. There's a tube inside and it's directly below the gear that comes through for elevation. So if you know what it is, please let us know. We are grateful for that information. And another hole is here for the gear that goes from the top to the bottom for driving the traverse. And then we have two holes here. A tube will be welded inside for a bolt, M16 bolt, to go through for clamping down a bracket that sits more or less like this underneath. And whenever it fires, the lip of the bracket will be catching below the lip of a curved part with the gear for traversing. And then at the bottom there will be two more holes that I need to cut with wheels inside that runs along a track. So I'm going to do that now. I'm going to cut off camera because it's very messy, and yeah, I think there's another video. I will put the link up, let me think, or right top corner. You see it, it's a grey link you can click, and then you can see it, the plasma cutting I did before. Holes on the inside are cut already, and as you can see on the bottom side, I have drilled a few holes so that I don't have to pierce with the plasma cutter, which can cause damage to the plasma cutter more easily than when starting on an edge. And as you can hear, the compressor is running, so I have to wait till it's full again, and then I can cut another few holes. As you can see, I have cut the holes inside. For the smaller ones, there's already a tube in, but I still need to weld it. It's for the bolt. This one goes right through. So I've got my flashlight from the phone. You can see there's a wall that I had to cut through as well. And the part that goes in here has the wheel that supports the front of the cradle, because the center weight of the gun is forward of the pivot point. So it needs to rest on two bearings. This is the other side. Those parts I still need to make is 15 mm wall thickness of tube with a block inside that houses a solid steel wheel, so not a bearing but just a metal disc, so to speak. And this tube is for the drive mechanism. You can see the wall again. The tube is for the drive mechanism for the drive gear of the traversing. And on the other side, you can see that portion is deeper, so that's about the height of the tube. And then on the top side of the tube will be a flange where the gear is mounted for driving. And this is the hole underneath the other gear, of which I don't know the purpose of. So if you know it, please let us know. And you can see this the mounting hole for the elevation gear. Now after these parts are in, and I need a few holes to be tapped right here, and those and on the other side the same. And on this one over there, I need to drill a hole through for a pin on both sides and for attaching the gear, which will be on this bracket on that side. And after that, I have to make sure that the slot will fit, and I have to make the barrel clamps And after those are finished, we can put this part on the Nashorn. As you can see, work is progressing. These tubes on this side I still need to weld. This flange is for connecting the gear for the traversing. Still need to weld it here, but also on the sides. This hole needs to be drilled. This I can bolt to the flange. And that one still needs to be welded. And then for the bottom part, I'm making these bushings. They need to be about 15 millimeter wall thickness. And turning the normal lathe is a lot of work and so expensive. I found a few pieces of tubing that fits together pretty well, and also need this cut out for like a spline on two sides, and then these need to fit inside. Need to clean them up a little bit. Need a slot inside for the wheel and a pin through, and then on the sides I need a pin or a square piece of stock welded in for making sure that this cannot turn. And then the wheel will sit like this. This is C45 steel, or it will cut the wheels out of it, and it will sit in like this, and it will support the cradle for traversing at the front side. I cut pieces of tubing and I clamped them together to make sure that the space in between is zero. Then I will weld it up here, and these are more or less coarse in size, and then I will have to file them down to make them fit. And here I'm filing one down. It's close to size, but it's a little bit oversized. If you do that at first, then it's more difficult to get the correct size. So I'll do the welding first and then do the filing later. I have welded the pieces, as you can see. Then next step is grinding with the grinding disc, and then using the sanding disc to make it all flush. As you can see, I'll place the round stock inside to see if it fits, marked it up, and next is cutting this slot. But now I will mark it with like a 1 and a 1, and then for this one a 2, and the other part also a 2, so I know these two fit together. As you can see, it fits loosely, so that's good. But with the keys that will go inside, it makes sure it doesn't turn anymore. So for this, the next job is to put it in the cradle. So I have finished this. I'll see if this still fits. There's some splatter on it, but it cleans off easily. It has some tight spots, so I have to grind this a little bit more, and then it will fit again. So this part fits now. It's time to mark it up. I use some black felt marker so that scratch lines are more obvious. (Clears So these marks with a scratch line, that's for the key that goes in it. And this one is for the slot for the wheel. But this is not the correct dimension, but only to point out where it will be. So these are for the wheels that support the cradle when it's traversing at the front. This is the main support bearing, the position for the main support bearing. These will go in like this. It's a bit of a tight fit. They will stick out about 5 or 6 millimeters. And this line will be have to be in line with the main bearing, because the wheel will be at a 90 degree angle to this line. So if this is correct, then the wheel will be on the correct angle for the turning radius it will be in. So that's the next thing to do. I had to grind this out a little bit, it was still a bit tight, so I couldn't turn it well. It's difficult to find the center, and don't have a center finder. But since it's only moving a little bit up and down, and it's not really at high speeds, so if it's a little bit off, it's not a big problem. But still, I want to get it as precise as possible. Both are pretty good in position now. We'll place a few tack welds and then check how vertical it is. It is very difficult to get it perfect. It would be best to place a roughly machined part in and then machine it when it's welded, then you can get it perfectly in line. But yeah, that's not possible for us unless you have a lot of extra money. So we'll have to do it like this. So this one is about level in this direction, we'll check here as well, and this one needs to go down a bit here. So this one is good, but this one is still in this angle not quite all right. So now I can only move it in that direction. I'm not really using the measurement on it, but I can see that I can still push it down. So here is too far down. So this one needs to go down to bring this part up. So now can weld this one already finished welded. Last video I told you, I don't know for what reason this bushing is in here. The gear that goes through here is right above this bushing, so maybe that has something to do with that. This one is the same type of bushing as this one. It's for driving the traverse, and that one for elevation. So I need to finish weld this bushing. I will have to drill another hole here, but I first needed the flange on the other side on it for the position. And I can finish these, and as I said, these are for supporting the entire cradle, the weight, because the center of gravity, the center of mass is the front of the main bearing. And these two are for the clamp that holds down when you shoot, and it wants to pivot like that. So it's upside down now. Then it will grab onto the gear and hold it in the position. You always find some more splatter that you forgot to take care of, especially after painting. So I have finished the welding. I'm going to put on some paint to finish everything up. And then for this part, except for tapping a few holes, it's finished. I need to make this part that bolts on here first, before I can mount it, otherwise I have to take off the part again. So I have a few more things to do before we can start mounting it. So I guess in about a month we should be able to mount the gun in the traverse on the Nashorn. And then of course we still need to make all the parts for moving the gears and everything. Or hopefully we can still find some. And that will be the most difficult part, because yeah, it has to be all very precise, it's all gears. They have to go around an angle, so that will not be easy. But we have plenty of other jobs to do, so we don't have to be bored. So, see you around for the next video, and hope you enjoyed this one. So thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe.